ஆழ்வார் எம்பெருமானார் ஜீயர் திருவடிகளை சரணம். வி ஆர் சீயிங் தி மீனிங்ஸ் ஃபார் ஸ்ரீ பகவத்கீதா. நவ் வி ஆர் இன் சிக்ஸ்த் சாப்டர். திஸ் அத்தியாயம் சாப்டர் இஸ் நோன் அஸ் அத்தியாத்ம யோக அபியாச யோகா. இட் இஸ் டாக்கிங் அபவுட் ஆத்ம சாட்சா்காரம், செல்ஃப் ரியலைசேஷன். Initially, Krishna explained the mindset one should be in for this process of dhyana, which will lead to self-realization. And then he explained the process, postures, and how to do this dhyana. And subsequently, he explained the four types of this dhyana yogis. One who can see all the atmas at the same level. One who can see the equivalence in all of the atmas. And the four stages were seen, starting from the first stage, where one sees that all the atmas are having jnana and ananda, and the second stage is to be able to see the connection or the similarity when all the atmas get liberated. When the atmas get liberated, they acquire 8 qualities from Brahman, Bhagavan, and based on that 8 qualities which they acquire, all the atmas are looked at in the same level. So this is the second stage. The third stage is to see all the atmas being connected with Bhagavan, being an inseparable attribute of Bhagavan. In that aspect, the similarity, equivalence of all the atmas are seen. And finally, the fourth stage is to be able to see the atma as a independent entity, even when it is in this material world, being able to disconnect the atma from the body. And even at the times of great joy or great sorrow, being undisturbed by all of that. So these four stages are explained by Krishna in 29, 30, 31 and 32 slokams. Now we are going to move on to 33rd slokam. In two slokams, Arjuna is inquiring from Krishna about how to get the control in the mind which is wavering all the time, and Krishna is explaining how to do that. And subsequently, Arjuna starts asking about the greatness of this Atma Sakshatkaram and the process to attain the Atma Sakshatkaram, and Krishna will answer that towards the end of this chapter. So let's start with 33rd ஸ்லோகம். அர்ஜுன உவாச்ச, யோகம் யோகஸ்த்வயா ப்ரோக்தஹ சாம்யேன மதுசூதன, ஏதஸ்யாஹம் ந பஷ்யாமி சஞ்சலத்வாத் ஸ்திதிம் ஸ்திராம். 34th ஸ்லோகம் இஸ் ஆல்சோ ரிசைட்டட் அலாங் அண்ட் தி மீனிங்ஸ் ஆர் ரிலேட்டட், சோ லெட் அஸ் சீ தட் அஸ் வெல். சஞ்சலம் ஹி மன கிருஷ்ண பிரமாதி பலவத் திருடம், தஸ்யாஹம் நிக்ரஹம் மன்யே வாயோரிவ சுதுஷ்கரம். வெரி இம்பார்ட்டன்ட் ஸ்லோகம்ஸ். திஸ் சஞ்சலம் ஹி மன கிருஷ்ண இஸ் ஆஃபன் கோட்டட் இன் தி வியாக்கியானம்ஸ், இன் தி காமெண்ட்ரிஸ், டு ஹைலைட் ஹவு தி மைண்ட் கேன் பி வேவரிங் ஆல் தி டைம் அண்ட் ஹவு டிஃபிகல்ட் இட் இஸ் டு கண்ட்ரோல் தி மைண்ட். Let us see the word by word meaning. Madhusudana, O Krishna, who killed the demon Madhu. Yaha, ayam, samyena yogaha. This yoga, which is vision of equality in all, the whole of yoga is about seeing the true nature of Atma and see how all the Atmas have the same qualities. Only due to the connection with the body, we see different Atmas behaving differently, having different qualities and so on. But the underlying Atma is having similar nature. So this vision of equality in all of them, Tvaya, by you, Proktaha, instructed. What is instructed by you? Yetasya stiram stitim. This yoga of remaining steadfast, chanchalatvat, due to wavering mind, napashyami, I am not seeing. O Krishna, who killed the demon Madhu, I am not seeing this yoga, which is vision of equality in all, and which is instructed by you. Remaining steadfast due to my wavering mind. So Arjuna is telling Krishna in this shlokam that due to my wavering mind, I am not able to see this vision of equality in all the Atmas, which was instructed by Krishna in great detail. 34th shlokam. Chanchalam himana Krishna pramati balavat dridam. Asyaham nigraham manye vayoriva sudushkaram. He, because manaha, mind is chanchalam, naturally wavering. Balavat, strong. Hence, pramati, bewildering. Dridam, firm in pulling us towards worldly pleasures. Tasya nigraham, restraining it. Vayoho, eva, like controlling a fierce storm. Sadushkaram, very difficult to do. Aham manye, I think. So it's continuing from the previous shlokam. Because mind is naturally wavering, strong, and hence bewildering, and firm in pulling us towards the worldly pleasures. I think that it is very difficult to restrain it, like controlling a fierce storm. Because my mind is very strong, at the same time it is wavering. It is bewildered, at the same time it is firm in worldly pleasures. Because of all of these reasons, I think it is very difficult to restrain it, to control it. How difficult is it? It is as difficult as controlling a fierce storm. Just as when the storm occurs, it is not possible to control anything in there. Similarly, it is very difficult to control and restrain the mind. We often think about something, even though that particular object may be miles away from us, it may not be possible for us to get it. But still the mind will hanker for it and will try to get it and will keep thinking about it. And it is uncontrollable at that time. That is the question here by Arjuna. And Krishna explains Arjuna on this particular topic in the next two shlokams. 35th shlokam, Shri Bhagavan Uvacha. Asamshayam Mahabaho Mano Durnigraham Chalam Abhyasena Tu Kaunteya Vairagyena Cha Grihyate. So Krishna is showing a way to control the mind to Arjuna. Let us see the word by word meanings here. Mahabaho, O mighty armed, Kaunteya, O son of Kunti, Chalam mana, the wavering mind. Chalam means one which is moving. So here the mind is always wavering, moving. Durnigraham is difficult to control. This wavering mind is very difficult to control. Asamshayam, there is no doubt about it. Two, still, abhyasena, by practicing in atmagunams, focusing on atma, by engaging the mind in atma and by practicing sattvagunam, vairagyena, developing aversion in worldly matters by showing their defects, grihyate, is controlled to some extent. So Krishna is saying in this shlokam that yes, the mind is wavering. It is very difficult to control it. There is no doubt about it. I agree with you. But still, there is a way to control it to some extent. It comes with practice. Practice of what? Practice of the process of meditation on focusing the mind on the Atma and developing Sattvagunam, the quality of goodness, and always having good thoughts, and also Vairagyena, by developing aversion, by developing detachment to worldly matters. And how can one develop detachment to worldly matters? That is by seeing the defects of the worldly matters. So we look at some pleasure in this material world. For example, we can see enjoying some food item. At the time of eating, when it touches the tongue, when it makes contact with the tongue, that food item will be very tasty. It will give joy. But beyond that point, once it passes through the mouth and goes to the stomach, then it may be good to the body, it may be bad to the body. So we can see the ultimate reaction of a particular pleasure. And when that pleasure is known to be leading to some bad results, then showing that result, we can convince our mind saying that, yes, it is good now, but in the end, we are going to suffer. So that is one type of defect on a particular object, which can be shown to the mind, and the mind can be convinced that way. Similarly, in general also, we can convince saying that all the material pleasures are both insignificant as well as temporary. We see something which is very joyful today, but tomorrow it may not be joyful. What was good for us 10 years ago need not be good for us now. So there is always the temporary aspect in all of the material aspects. Similarly, any pleasure we get, they are insignificant in the larger scheme of things. Today it may be something great, but if we look back 5 years down the road, then we will see, oh, why did I hanker for that particular pleasure? It is nothing. So there is the insignificance aspect is also there. Showing these defects, the mind can be controlled to some extent. Now this is like, we are in a bad situation, now we have to improve, and then once there is some progress, then we can improve it further and further and further and so on. So initially our mind is wavering, so we have to show something to the mind to control it. Once there is some control, then we can do more meditation, more dhyana, and we can improve it further, and then there will be more scope for convincing the mind. It cannot be done in one day, so it has to be done progressively. And that is explained here by Krishna in this process. So practice is very important. Continuous repetitive dhyanam, repetitive engagement in good activities will lead to detachment in the worldly pleasures, and then mind will be somewhat pacified and the progress will be visible in such cases. Next, 36th shlokam, Krishna is continuing on. Explaining this, asamyatatmana yogo dushprapa iti me matihi vashyatmana tu yatata shakyo vaptum upayatah. Asamyatatmana, one who cannot control his mind, yogaha, yoga of having equal vision, dushprapaha, difficult to attain, iti is me matihi, my conclusion, tu, but upayataha, by the means of karma yoga, which was explained previously, vashyatmana, having controlled mind, here atma is explained as mind in some cases, so here vashyatmana means having control over mind. So, having controlled his mind, yatata, one who performs yoga practice of samadarshana, equal vision, avaptum shakyate, becomes easy to attain. So, Krishna is saying, my conclusion is, this yoga of having equal vision is difficult to attain for the one who cannot control his mind. But, for the one who performs yoga practice, of samadarshana, equal vision, after having controlled his mind by the means of karma yoga, this equal vision becomes easy to attain. Yes, it is generally very difficult to attain this self-realization for those who cannot control their minds. But if one is engaged in this yoga practice, due to having done karma yoga, which already has purified the individual to some extent, this yoga practice helps, and then this equal vision becomes easy to attain. So with this, Krishna explains that yes, it is difficult to control the mind, but one has to control the mind, and that can be done by showing the defects of the worldly pleasures, which is what the mind is hankering for. And once that is done, then one can move on to the practice of yoga and then attain this samadarshanam, this equal vision, which will eventually lead to self-realization. After this, Arjuna questions Krishna about the greatness of this yoga practice again and the ultimate result of self-realization, Atma-Sakshatkaram, and let us see that portion now. 37th Shlokam, Arjuna Uvacha. Ayati Shraddhayo Peto Yoga Chalitam Anasaha Aprapya Yoga Samsiddhim Kam Gatim Krishna Gacchati. Let us see the word by word meanings. Krishna, O Krishna, Shraddhaya, faithfully, Upetaha, who began the yoga practice, Ayatihi, lacking efforts in firm yoga practice, and as a result of that lack of efforts, Yoga Samsiddhim Aprapya, while his yoga is not fulfilled, Yogat Chalitamanasaha, having a heart which slipped in the yoga practice, Kamgatim, which goal among enjoyment, liberation or hell, gacchati, will reach. So Arjuna is asking, O Krishna, if one faithfully begins this yoga practice, but lacks efforts in firm yoga practice, and as a result of that, is having a heart which slipped in the yoga practice, even while his yoga is not fulfilled, which goal will such person reach? So for someone who started the yoga practice, that it be karma yoga, jnana yoga, bhakti yoga, and he did not complete the practice, he did not attain the fulfillment, and at that stage, let's say he slips, he stops the yoga practice, what happens to him? Asks Arjuna. Next shlokam, kachin no bhaya. Vibhrashtaschinna brahmiva nashyati. Apratishto mahabaho vimudo brahmanaspati. This is 38th shlokam. Word by word meanings. Mahabaho, O mighty armed, brahmanaha pati vimudaha. Being cut off from the yoga, path of karma yoga, of attaining brahmam. So here yoga is tied with karma yoga. This dhyana is also a part of karma yoga and jnana yoga. Everything is interconnected. So it's all talked about together here. Attaining brahmam. Apratishtaha, not fixed in goals such as heaven, etc. In this manner, ubhaya vibhrashtaha, missing out both on bhogam of this worldly enjoyment and moksham, liberation. Chinna brahm iva, like a divided cloud, kachinna nashyati, will he not be destroyed? So Arjuna is asking in this shloka, O mighty armed Krishna, such person who is cut off from the yoga path because of attaining Brahman, because he slipped in the process and is not fixed in the goals for that particular yoga. In this manner, missing out on both bhogam, worldly enjoyment, because he is pursuing yoga, he will not be interested in worldly enjoyment, bhogam, and because he slipped in this process, he will not attain liberation as well, moksham as well. So will such person not be destroyed like a divided cloud? So if the cloud breaks into pieces, it's neither going to rain nor it's going to have its state. So, in that case, that cloud becomes wasted. So, Krishna is being questioned by Arjuna here. What happens to such persons who start the process and then eventually not be able to complete it? In that case, will they not be destroyed totally, losing out on both worldly pleasure as well as ultimate liberation? Next, 39th question. All these three shlokams are questions posed by Arjuna. So we'll see them together. Yetanme samshayam Krishna chetum arhasya sheshataha. Tvadanyaha samshayasyasya cheta na hyupapadyate. So Arjuna is saying in this shlokam that he has no one to go and ask these questions, which is a very good sign. If we fully depend on Bhagavan to clarify our doubts and give us clear guidance, he will be more than happy to do that. And that's what Krishna did here. Krishna, O Krishna, my etan samshayam, this doubt, asheshataha, fully, chetum arhasi, please clear. Asya, samshayasya, cheta, one who can clear this doubt, tvadanyaha, none other than you, nahi upapadyate, is qualified. O Krishna, please clear this doubt of mine fully. None other than you are qualified to clear this doubt. So in this question, Arjuna is saying to Krishna that these are my doubts. I have no one else to ask these doubts. So you have to clarify them. You are the most qualified person to clarify these doubts. So with this, we will stop today. We will see Krishna's answers in the next class. ஆழ்வார் எம்பெருமானார் ஜியர் திருவடிகளே சரணம்.
டு லேர்ன் சச் வேல்யூபிள் இன்ஃபர்மேஷன் அபவுட் அவர் ஸ்ரீ வைஷ்ணவ சம்பிரதாய பிளீஸ் டவுன்லோட் கோயில் KOYIL ஆப் ஃப்ரம் கூகுள் பிளே ஸ்டோர் ஆர் ஆப்பிள் ஆப் ஸ்டோர். அவர் வெப்சைட் இஸ் koyil.org KOYIL.org.